Hey guys, Bitter here to do an album review. Today I'm here to tell you all about the latest album from Deathwhite, Grave Image, out January 31st on Season of Mist. This album has 10 tracks, 49 minutes in length, and this is the band's second full-length studio album. This is a melodic doom metal band from Pittsburgh, and they deliver a very strong and powerful record. As you look at the lyrical and musical soundscapes of the album, you're left reflecting about humankind and perhaps our demise when you look at how words and actions have taken control of people and have taken control of our society. Listening to this record and listening to the messages on the songs, I was left wondering how much of this album really connects with what's happening in today's society from a political perspective, but also from a socioeconomic perspective. So there's a lot of things that you can find that correlate to your day-to-day life, and perhaps listening to an album like this will make you reflect on some of your own choices, some of your own actions, some of your own words that you use on a daily basis that perhaps bring pain, bring suffering, but also bring a false sense of superiority and a false sense of having your moral compass pointing towards the right direction. So there's a lot to digest from this album, and it did it in a very subtle way, in a way that is not really in your face, in a way that doesn't come across as being the owners of the truth and the owners of the right. They're just talking about things that they see, things that they perceive to be dangerous, and in the way that they did it, it was in a very subtle way, similar to the way their sound and their style and their approach to this record is, a very subtle way of creating a very heavy record. To me, overall, this album has to be divided in two main components, sound and vocals. Obviously, when you look at the sound, then it obviously plays into the structure of the album and plays into the structure of the tracks. But if you're looking at the two main driving forces, the two main ingredients of this record, you really have to look at sound and vocals, and then obviously at the cooperation between the two. I want to start off by talking about the sound. I felt that this album has a very unique melodic doom metal sound to it. The way I felt about this record is that this record is almost like a river. From the point it starts to the point where it meets the ocean, you go through different stages. Some parts of the river are a lot wider, some are a lot narrower, some are a little bit slower. Then you have the rapids where it increases in speed and intensity and aggression, if you will. And this record is a little bit like that. This record is like a river when you look at the overall sound that it has. It has some moments where it's more calm, more subdued, more melancholic. And then you have some moments where it's more aggressive, more intensive, and has a lot more dynamic to it. Really interesting way of creating an album like this, for sure, because the sound and the dynamic changes that the sound has really provides intensity and darkness in a perfect symbiosis. This album really marries these two effects. It really marries the melancholic side of the record, the melancholic side of doom metal, if you will, with a more aggressive side. And it does it in a perfect way. It doesn't do it on a track-by-track basis. It does it within each single track. You really feel the mood changes, the mood swings within the tracks, but it's done in such a perfect way. It's done in such a harmonious way that you don't feel the changes. By the time you realize the song is picked up on aggression or intensity, you're already halfway through that portion, and you're already coming out at the end of it, going into a more melancholic part of the song. So they did a very perfect job, I would say. They did a wonderful job mixing these two worlds together in order to create an album that has a lot of life, that has a heartbeat built within its sound. Now, from a vocals perspective, to me, the vocals are the glue that holds this record together. When you look at an album like this, you're almost tempted to put harsh vocals somewhere in it, in a chorus or a little bit in the pre-chorus, a little bit in the verse. Almost in any given record that has this type of sound, this type of dynamic fluidity within its sound, you feel very tempted to do that. They didn't do that at all. You're gonna get clean vocals all the way through, and I really feel that the vocals is the glue that holds this whole album together. Without that steady element, that very linear element of having clean vocals and never really deviating from that path on any song on the record, it really allows the album to feel together as one. You really feel that the vocals are the main character of the story, and he's just going through different facets of the story, different facets of his life within each song and then overall within the record. And that is what gives the album dynamic. But the vocals, the style, and the way it comes at you with such a somber and dark feel, but at the same time with a lot of built up anger and intensity, it's really what holds it all together and allows this album to feel as one. It's really a unifying force, something that you're going to find as a common denominator throughout the whole record and on every single track. It's really something that aggregates the album together, that really brings it together. And that to me was one of the great elements that this album had to offer, was how beautiful the clean vocals were, how enigmatic they were, the ability to provide you with emotion through the way the vocals are coming at you, and to really emphasize the emotion in the lyrics and not letting other factors really deter your attention away from it. So I really applaud them for having this approach on this record, because it worked to perfection. In conclusion, let me say this about this album. This is an absolute standout record. It was an absolute surprise to me, because this was my first time listening to this band and I was not expecting an album this consistent, this well thought out, this well processed. To me, this album was perfectly produced, perfectly drafted, perfectly balanced, perfectly executed, and perfectly delivered. That's the best way to describe the overall feel of Grave Image. Now, as far as songs are concerned, I really want to start off with In Eclipse, strong, heavy opening on this song, with the drums and guitars together, both having this really strong symbiosis of forces, if you will. The heaviness really blends with the melancholy as the vocals come in during the verses. The vocals really unify the track, if you will. You still get these bursts of intensity, of energy, if you will, sprinkled throughout. They did a really good job of creating a song that has slow moments and then has more dynamic moments. And during some of those more dynamic moments, they used still clean vocals, but a really darker style of clean vocals. They really feel like they're in the distance, and that adds a little bit of a somber vibe to the track. The chorus is very dark. From a vocal perspective, not necessarily from a musical perspective. From a musical perspective, I felt that it was a lot heavier. The chorus had a lot more volume to it. But this, to me, is a track that merges perfectly melancholy and heaviness. You really get a symbiosis of these two worlds. They're perfectly blended together. You get a little bit of one, a little bit of the other, and then they use the vocals as the connecting point in order to merge those different styles and those different approaches within the same track. Next, No Horizon, a song that is made up of incredible peaks and excruciating valleys. This song is an absolute roller coaster of a track. There's no middle ground. It's either left or right. It's either up or down. That is the dynamic fluidity that this track has. And in my opinion, it gives the song such momentum. It gives the song such, it's really like a heartbeat. And you feel like with every peak, the heart pumps and then it retracts with every valley. I really feel that way about this song. It has such energy. Mixing really haunting vocals with the more stripped out portions, the more melancholic portions of the track, works really well. It really allows the song to feel a lot more intense during those specific portions, and allows the song to have a lot more life, a lot more meaning, and the vocals have a little bit more emotion built in into them. Great, beautiful guitar melody to close off the track, and it really represents well the overall feel and atmosphere and mood that this song has. Next, Plague of Virtue, one of my favorite songs on the album, perhaps because I really connected with the lyrics and the message, because I really feel like we live in a world that's plagued with virtue. Everybody claims the high road. So I really feel like this song, from a personal perspective in terms of what the lyric content was, I really connected with it, because that's something that I personally struggle with it, and I struggle on how to deal with it. So it's really interesting to listen to a song that had this kind of a topic, that had this kind of a subject matter, and I connected to it. So maybe perhaps that's one of the reasons where I really gravitated towards it and why this is my favorite song. I really like the guitar riff in this track. The vocals come in with some layers. This is one of those songs where they added a little bit of backing vocals to the main vocals in order to give it more volume and more texture. The vocals are really stripped out overall. The clean vocals are really melodic, really stripped down. So on a song like this that has a lot of built up intensity, if you will, a lot of built up emotion, you really needed something on the vocals. And if you're not going to do harsh vocals, which they don't do in the record, I really believe that adding layers to the vocals, backing tracks, really adds that, because you add volume or you add texture, you make the vocals feel heavier without having heavy vocals in it. I also really enjoy the use of the bass. It really peeks its head out in different parts of the song. It becomes a lot noticeable throughout the track, and it to me is a way for you to counterbalance all the melody that you get from the guitars on this track. So you have the bass adding a little bit of darkness, creating this more somber vibe to a song that has a lot of melody, both from a vocal perspective, but more so from a guitar perspective. Really powerful chorus. it really increases in emotion and in heaviness. To me, it is the strong point of the song. It is where all the emotional heaviness comes together. Not just emotion and heaviness, emotional heaviness comes together in the course of this song, making one of the more powerful and pungent choruses throughout this whole record. A song that, in my opinion, really hides a truthful and dark message, like I said, not only in the lyrics, but in the beauty that it has in the melody of the track. They did this song to perfection, and they really constructed a very powerful and emotional track. All right, guys, this is it. This is Deathwhite, Grave Image, out January 31st on Season of Mist. Wonderful record. If you're a fan of doom metal, if you're a fan of melodic doom metal, this is a record that you cannot skip. I'll guarantee you, you're not gonna find one single bad song out of the 10 songs on this record. All right, let me know your thoughts on the band. Use the comment section below. I'll be reading those and getting back to you. Take care, guys.